The Hillary Clinton nightmare continues. You won't believe where she just applied to work at. Looks like Hillary Clinton has something up her sleeve. You'd think after the elections, she would realize it was time to call it quits and let President Trump do his job, but nope, she will be going to different colleges and universities and lecturing on her agenda without any type of restrictions. She has her eye on teaching at one school in particular. Columbia University. Vibrant Bart. Failed presidential candidate Hillary Clinton is plotting her next move after the release of her book last month and is reportedly looking at taking a formal teaching role at the Ivy League Columbia University. The New York Daily News reports that Clinton is in discussions for a flexible role that would allow the former Secretary of State to lecture across schools and departments without the requirement of a strict course. Clinton has the background for it, as a former law professor at the Arkansas School of Law, but a source with knowledge of Clinton's thinking told the Daily News that no decisions have been made, but there are talks. Clinton is also reportedly in discussions to house her archives at the prestigious university. She's trying to figure out what she wants to do. It could end up with the papers at one place and she has some sort of faculty role at another. She hasn't quite come to a decision, the source said. Clinton released her campaign post-mortem what happened last month, fueling a fresh round of speculation of what will be next for her. She has set up her own political fundraising group, Onward Together, and has been on a lengthy speaking tour surrounding the release of the tome. Ahead of the book's release, there were reports that she was considering delving more into preaching, becoming a Methodist lay preacher. I think it would be more of her guest preaching at some point, Clinton's pastor, Bill Shillady, said. We have a long history of lay preachers in the United Methodist Church. And more about her book tour where she demeans the women her husband sexually harassed. During a portion of an interview set to air on Sunday's edition of BBC One's The Andrew Marr Show, former Democratic presidential nominee Hillary Clinton defended how her book treats the women who accused Bill Clinton of sexual misconduct. After Hillary talked about Harvey Weinstein, anchor Andrew Marr asked Hillary if the way her book kind of dismissed the women who accused Bill Clinton of sexual misconduct and appeared at one of the debates at Donald Trump's behest was the right thing to do. She answered, well, yes. Because that had all been litigated. I mean, that was the subject of a huge investigation, as you might recall, in the late 90s. And there were conclusions drawn. And that was clearly in the past. Hillary Clinton, Trump is insidious and subversive to democracy. Monday at the University of California Davis, former Democratic presidential candidate Hillary Clinton said President Donald Trump was insidious and subversive to democracy. Clinton said, there is no such thing as an alternative fact. And despite the best efforts by some to wage war on truth, reason, and evidence, we cannot let that happen. She continued, when leaders deny things we can see with our own eyes, like the size of a crowd of an inauguration, it is just frustrating to us that pride ourselves on living in a fact-based universe. It is insidious and subversive to democracy. And when they refuse to accept evidence on everything from the settled science of climate change, to what is actually being proposed, because all you have to do is read it, in their so-called tax reform it has real-world consequences that will only get worse. She added, just last week the Trump administration announced a new rule that would allow any employer or insurance company to refuse to cover contraception if they have a religious or moral objection. Now that just doesn't undermine every woman's right to make her own health decisions. It flies in the face of medicine, science, and facts. Thanks to decades of hard work and investment in prevention, American is now at a 30-year low of unintended pregnancy, a 40-year low for teen pregnancy, and the lowest abortion rate since Roe v. Wade was decided. And no matter your political party or ideology, that has something to do with access to birth control. There is a problem with this, in my opinion, because it is bad enough that the school institutions are liberal as they are, with Hillary Clinton going around with no set curriculum, but her own agenda is very dangerous. It is bad enough that the students of these institutions censor conservative speakers, or treat conservative speakers very disrespectfully, But now imagine the scary impact of the Queen of Snowflakes influencing these students with no rules or regulations could keep the youth of Americans in the self-entitlement phase that could lead them to groups like Antifa. We know the destruction of Antifa with the riots, looting, and other crimes they commit when they do not get their way. Don't get me wrong, Hillary Clinton has the right to move on with her life, and do the things she wants to do. As a conservative American, just think it is only right that she does this with regulated school guidelines. I do not trust her professionally and personally given her past when she worked for the United States State Department, and as a senator in New York. Seriously, her irresponsible deletion of 30,000 emails, her lack of leadership at Benghazi, her socialistic ideology of "it takes a village" are just some of the reasons why I wouldn't want her to have a free rein in universities. As a parent, I totally disagree with this and I believe that there should be restrictions on this. Reason being that the United States is a democracy, a constitutional republic, where there are people who have different values and political beliefs where they should all have equal opportunities.